Oh. Hey there. My name is Landon Huber, and I'm a graphic illustrator, a musician, and a comic book artist. I also do surrealist painting. In this video, I will be showing you my creative process. You will get to see how I created this artwork of Frankenstein's monster lurking in the woods. This art was first just an idea, starting with a thumbnail sketch. Then, on 11 by 14 bristle board, I pencil, ink, then color it with watercolors. I hope you will enjoy watching my process. In the video, I will try to explain my thinking throughout the various steps, interspersed with music as you watch me draw and paint. For more information about me, contact info, or for information on purchasing original art, please see the description below. So now, without any further ado, let's begin. So this is usually how I start. I usually start by doing a quick little thumbnail. This one is just on a scrap piece of paper and 1/2 by 11. And that gives me an idea of where I want to go with the final drawing. So the first thing I want to do is figure out what the parameters of my drawing are. I have a box to deal with, the paper itself, and I want to make sure that what I'm drawing is going to fill up the right amount of the paper, as well as give me enough space to put a background, because I don't want to go outside the edge of the box. The box is the paper, but even the paper itself is part of the composition overall. First here, I'm just trying to get inside the mind of Frankenstein's monster. Trying to work out what does he think like? Basically, for any drawing, you want to try to bring it to life inside your head first, so you have something to work with when you start putting these lines down on a piece of paper. And you start by just blocking in the shapes. You see, I've already indicated a moon. And so I know that I want the lighting to be coming from behind him. I want to have shadows falling across him. And also because I know I'm going to be coloring this later with watercolors, I'm going to leave plenty of open white areas in the art to color in with color. Drawing in some folds, some more shadows, and creases in the clothing, rips. I like drawing rips on everything. Just think it looks cool. But you can see I drew the back foot foreshortened because it's going into the background, with the front foot getting bigger because it's coming out towards us. And I'm just working around various
areas of the drawing. I don't really like to get, especially when I'm first starting, I don't really want to get stuck too long in one area, because sometimes I just like to jump around the drawing. Kind of makes me feel like I'm getting it done faster too. Patience is an important thing. If you're gonna make art, if you're gonna do drawings, you have to learn patience. Because every single line, every mark, everything you do on the page is gonna change it. And it takes patience. You need to focus. Going from a white paper to now we got something going here. And now I'm just working on the details of the hands. There's certain areas you do have to slow down and sit there and work out the details. The more you get finished on the drawing, the more you find yourself doing that. But right here I'm getting all the shadowing and wrinkles and the fingernails and the drips and the, just getting it down, everything I want to see there. To me, the backgrounds are very important. Without a background, your character just looks like he's floating in on a white space. Or something. The background gives you a setting. So I'm going in the background, I'm indicating little twigs from a tree that I want falling down. Just trying to put it together in my mind. As close as I can. In general, keeping the lines a little bit thinner in the background than the ones on the character. And again, I know I'm going to be coloring this, so all those leaves are going to end up being watercolored over. And I'm just going into the background, adding details now. Thank you. So I'm inking here with the Winsor & Newton Series 7 number 1 brush. It's probably my favorite brush. I have a set, I have number 1, 0, 2, 3, and I even have a 4. But it's probably true that this one's my favorite just because I like the size. Gives me the thin and the right amount of thin to thick. And I can get a lot of ground covered with just this one brush, number 1. So, it could be that inking is my most favorite part of the creative process, what I'm doing here. I just like going into the zone when I'm inking, because you're not thinking as much about the construction of everything as you are just getting those lines down and thinking of line weights. And I just like the magic of it, of it going from this sketchy pencil drawing to this more finished looking inked drawing. Keeping in mind where the shadows are, but I'm just going in there now and detailing it out, working around the drawing bit by bit. It could be true that the face is the most important part of the drawing. That's the part where you look into the soul of the person or thing or creature that you're drawing. It's very important to capture that when you're drawing the face, so never rush faces. That's the one place you need to make sure you're conveying what you want. But having said that, it is true that every part of the drawing is equally important. The whole thing needs to work as a cohesive whole. And so it's a good idea to sometimes step back, take a look at your drawing from a distance as well as close up. But when you're doing the face, I always like to get in there. Sometimes I even wear my magnifying glasses. Just doing some hatching on the chest there. I usually like to try and incorporate some kind of surreality in my art, and shadows that stretch and fall and contort on the floor, on the ground that people are standing over. That's a good place to mess around with that, so even if it's not 100% accurate as to what it should be doing, I like to use my imagination when I'm drawing things like that. Maybe make it a little abstract. So now I'm just going into the background, drawing the foliage, drawing the trees, drawing the rocks. Keeping in mind that it's nighttime and the moon is cast over it, and also that I'm going to be coloring this all. And if I can somehow find a way to incorporate subliminal skull head in the most pictures that I draw, I'll find a way to do it. So that looks like a skull, but it's actually just some rocks. Drawing the twigs one by one. Getting it down. So at this point, the drawing is pretty much inked and finished. Now I just need to erase it. Erase out the pencils. I'm using a kneaded eraser, which you can buy at any art store. You rip it apart to clean it. And I find that using a kneaded eraser prevents the erasing from picking up the ink, which is a problem anybody who inks traditionally will tell you. But I don't think it's totally necessary to get rid of every single visible pencil line, but you just wanna give it a good once over. So some of you might be asking yourselves, hey, wait, I thought he was finished. I thought the inking was finished. But actually, there's one final step I do. And I'm just using a micron here, an 05, you could use an 01, 02, whatever you want. And going in and to do the very final details after I erase it. And with that, if I'm totally happy, I step back, take a look at it. And now, the inking is truly finished. At this point, I usually scan it. And you can see here on my computer, I've already scanned it. And I'm scanning it at 600 DPI, black and white. And I don't have any image correction or anything. But there you go. So now, in case anybody in the future wants to recolor it, or in case I want to recolor it, there it is, in the black and white. All right. So these are going to be the watercolors I'm going to be using today. They're Winsor & Newton brand. And I also have a set of gouache here. I won't be using a lot of this, but maybe just a little bit of white when I go in and do the highlights at the end. Gouache has a little more opaqueness to it. And as you can see here, my palette is just an old plate. You don't need a ton of colors, but you do need a red, a yellow, and a blue. And I usually like to have a black and white in there as well. And then you just start going in there coloring. I'm gonna start putting in the yellow around the edges of him, kind of glowing and highlighting because the moon is yellow, so the moon is gonna be highlighting behind him. I know it's gonna be a night scene, so there's gonna be a lot of blue. Because at night, things tend to have a bluish hue to them. But to make it interesting, you need to have other colors besides just blue. And Frankenstein being made of dead people's skin, can have a greenish hue to it. Add interest, I'm adding in some color into the sky, a fuchsia tone, just using a big brush, kind of dry brush effect in there. I tend to go back and forth between brushes a lot when I'm coloring. I'll work with one brush for a while, and then if I need to cover a big area, I'll switch to another brush. You go between using dry or wet techniques. With watercolors, you can even lift the color a little bit if you don't like what you put down. But unlike with digital, with doing this traditionally, you really want to try to think ahead. You have to look at it and try to imagine what it's going to look like before you start putting stuff down. Because you don't have endless, you know, fixes like you do with digital. Right there, I'm using an opaque technique to put in some leaves for the background. The rest of this is mostly washes. I'm just going in there and getting a little bit darker, adding in layers of color. In the interest of time, I'm skipping ahead. You're not seeing the entire process, but I'm trying to show you an idea of what goes on here. And even at this point, there's still quite a ways to go. Now I'm just going in and adding the all-important details on the skull rock. Detailing the moon using a slight orange hue. Thank you. So now as I'm looking at this, I'm realizing that I need to kind of darken up the whole picture. I need to start getting the feeling of the light coming from the moon and then fading into shadow and darkness around the edges more. Having a blow dryer on hand is a must. This is actually my wife's blow dryer. She was kind enough to let me borrow it. As long as I promise not to break it. I'm drying the layers so I can go in with the final touches. So what I'm doing now is going in there and actually lifting up some of the paint that I put down. You can see that I'm actually lifting up the watercolors with a dry brush, and every time I lift it, I'm wiping it on a paper towel, then going back, lifting a little more, wiping it. I'm just trying to get like little highlights and stuff in there that I wanted. And usually you have to wet it down first before you do this a little bit. Get a brush and wet the area you want to lift a little bit, and then dry it off. Lift it with the dry brush. Wipe it. Now at this point, as I'm getting closer to the end of an illustration, I will usually pick a color like a red or a blue, and I look around the picture and I get some of that color on my brush, and I basically go around the entire picture. You can see here using pretty, like I'd say, mid-sized brush actually, and I'm hitting different areas that I feel need that hue in there. And with watercolors, the color will kind of mix with the color that's already on the paper. I just use my intuition to know where and how that will happen to best serve the art. And now I'm putting on my magnification goggles. +3.5 magnification. I'm using them to go in and see the details better, especially on the face here. Final details, I need them. They really help me see the artwork much bigger and more clearly. Picture is almost finished. I'm just adding in the final highlights using an opaque white gouache with just a little bit of yellow mixed in. At this point, I'm pretty much just painting and not worried about covering up line art or anything like that. Thank you.
And now, it is finished. Looks kind of angry, but heck, if we were all half-rotted zombies, we'd probably be angry too. Put it in the finished pile. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching my creative process today. I know that I enjoyed showing it to you. It's important that as an artist, we enjoy what we do. The tough part is, as you keep doing it and your skills improve, you keep moving the bar up and up and up. But don't worry, because if you love it, you will keep doing it. And as you keep doing it, you will get better. It's in the striving where we find improvement. That's my philosophy anyways. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, be creative.
For now.